click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about the chemical reactivity of the group 13 elements, and as well as in that case we have also talked about that how boron has been reacting differently compared to that of the other one. So now let me talk about the anomalous property of the boron in this topic. So let us discuss about that. So talking about the anomalous property or different properties that are been exhibited by boron compared to that of the group 13 elements, and those are, talking about the first point, that is, the boron is a non-metal while the other members are metals. Yes, boron is the one which has a smaller atomic size, and that is, it has more electronegativity compared to that of the other one, as well as the ionization enthalpy of boron is also basically more, and that's the reason that there are many reasons so that we could say that the boron is the one which is acting like a non-metal. And talking about the electronegativity, so metals are those elements which are basically, they are more electropositive. And that's the reason that boron is the one which is more electronegative in the whole periodic, in the whole group 13 element. So that's the reason that boron is basically a non-metal, while the other members are metallic in nature. Might be aluminium, gallium, and that is thallium. So they all are basically, they have metallic character in them. So now let us talk about the second point, and that is, boron show allotropy while the other members do not. Yes, we have discussed earlier also, that is, the boron has an allotropy, means like it can be in a crystalline form also, while the boron can also be in an amorphous form. While the boron which is in the form of crystal, it cannot, it is not reacted easily with that of the oxygen molecule, but meanwhile the amorphous boron that reacts with oxygen so as to form a particular oxide. So therefore there are different kind of property or different allotropes of the boron, that is what we could that we have found, and while the others, they don't have the allotropy. So this was the second point that I was talking about, and the second difference, that how basically boron is different from the other metals of the same group 13 element. And now let us move on to the third point, and that is, so talking about the next one, that is, the boron has a highest melting point and boiling point. So this is because of the smaller atomic size, and because of the smaller atomic size and the electronegativity, so that's the reason that boron is basically a hard metal or a hard element in the group 13. And that's the reason that since it is very much hard, so therefore the energy required so as to melt it or so as to boil it, it also requires more energy, and that's the reason that boron has high melting and boiling point. While talking about the other aluminium, so aluminium is a soft element or soft metal compared to that of boron, and that's the reason that it has lower melting and boiling point compared to that of boron. And so this was the third point, and now let us move on to the next point, and that is, boron forms only covalent compounds. Yes, so even this is the main thing that I want to talk about, that is, while the other elements like that of the aluminium and all, so they can exhibit ionic compound as well as they can form covalent compounds, but boron is the one that forms covalent compounds only, and that's the reason that it is comparatively different from that of the other elements, and the properties also a bit different compared to that of the other elements belonging to the same group 13. And now let us move on to the next one, that is, the fifth point, it says that the oxides and the hydroxides of boron are basically weakly acidic. So boron oxide is basically acidic in nature, but the thing is, it is weakly acidic. While talking about the other one, like suppose if you are talking about oxide of aluminium, like Al2O3. So Al2O3 is basically amphoteric in nature. While talking about the last one, that is thallium. So thallium oxide is basically, it is weakly basic in nature. So that's the reason that the property also changes along the group 13 group or the elements, and in which basically the boron is the one which is acidic in nature. Or boron oxide is basically acidic in nature. So this was the fifth point, and there are also further points that I want to talk about, so let me discuss about that also, and those are, and those points are related to hydrides right now. So boron hydride is basically, it is quite stable, it is more stable, while the other hydrides, like suppose if I am talking about AlH3, so aluminium hydride, it's not that much stable as compared to that of BH3. So that's the reason that boron is also different. It's showing a different property compared to other one. And the last point, let me talk about that, that is, boron combines with the other active metals so as to form, that is, borides. So the other active metals in this case, basically we know that the S block elements, they are very much active in nature, and that's the reason they are more electropositive. And suppose if we are talking about the element like boron, so boron belongs to P block, while it can also react with that of the S block elements or the active metals so as to form a particular compound known as borite. So let me discuss about the reaction that happens, and this is only the reaction that is the boron in the whole group 13 element it exhibits. So suppose if I'm talking about boron, like suppose 2 moles of boron, it reacts with that is 3 moles of magnesium. Suppose if I take any active metal, so the product that we could form is basically Mg3B2. So the name of this compound is basically known as magnesium boride. So this is what I was talking about, and so these are the few points that easily shows that how boron, being the group 13 element, means all the group 13 elements should exhibit the same property, but still the boron is the one which is showing a different property compared to that of the other elements in the same group. So that's it. This is what I want to talk about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know the various different properties that are been exhibited by boron. And thank you for watching this video. I hope you'll share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.